हेलो सूरज डे आपको ओवरवेलमिंग मेजोरिटी ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स हैव बीन ऑनलाइन। मेरे को बीच बीच में ऐसा लगा था कि ओह माय गॉड वेरी गुड वेरी गुड बच्चा आने लगा है ना, दे आर द होप्स ऑफ शो कर दी ओनली अरुण इज लेट मी शेयर माय स्क्रीन एंड देन विल बी Okay, not audible properly. Oops. Is it properly audible now? Again, a confirmation, please. Miss Heli and all the students there. Pooja, you can confirm this. Jalpa and Dara.
Done, sir.
Okay, good. So Pooja is getting it properly. Heli, can you just confirm it again? Jalpa, can you hear me there?
Yes, sir.
And Dhara?
Yes, sir.
So Heli, only you are facing some problems, I guess. There will be some problem from your end.
No, sir.
You are not able to still properly.
So getting up, your voice is low.
My voice is low.
Yes.
I think my earphone is connected now. Is it coming proper? Can you check it over there, Aruna? Is it coming proper? Aruna has joined from this as well. Good to see that. Aruna, is it audible there? Voice is low. What could be the?
Okay, is it audible?
Okay, yes, right. Sir. Now,
yes, sir.
So there is some problem with the earphone today. Good to see that. Anyway, let's move ahead. सब पीपल लोग एक उसमें क्या गुड टू सी अब क्या नए बड़े नए मिलेंगे ना इसलिए गुड टू सी सो आई एम देयर राइट नाउ इन द मेथड्स ऑफ डिमांड फॉरकास्टिंग सो लेट मी जस्ट गिव यू द ब्रीफ आइडिया अबाउट व्हाट वी हैड डन लास्ट टाइम अराउंड वी हैड इफेक्टिवली डन द कैरेक्टराइजेशन ऑफ द एंटायर मार्केट मिस अरुणा When I say the characterization, that means we are trying to figure out the entire market after doing the secondary analysis and also going through the primary kinda analysis by doing the market survey. So these are the various points which were forming the characterization of the entire demand and market. Just a brief overview. The one was we could identify the effective demand in the past and present. What was the amount of demand we had in the past and right now? The breakdown of demand could be based on the consumer preferences. It could be based on the demographic variables. It could be based on the types of products. When I say background, that means you try to further categorize your demand into various categories. Price. What's the price for the manufacturers, wholesalers? Retailers, what is the price which will get the acceptance from the people? Which price will be a little bit overpriced when it comes to the end use customer buying? Methods of distribution and sales promotion, consumers, supply and competition, and government policy. So once you are clear with that, then you are a little bit ready about forecasting the actual demand. When I say the forecasting of the actual demand, the two things comes into the picture. One is you try to forecast the demand of the entire market. Number two thing, Ms. Aruna, and all the students who are listening here, is you try to forecast the demand of your product. One is the entire market. Number two, what would be your percentage of a share in the entire market? So two perspectives we are looking right now. Okay, so let me just give you the brief idea about all the types of methods that we are going to see here. sharing the slideshow here. So there are certain qualitative methods which does not involve the data analysis directly from your part. You are taking the opinions of the people and you are relying on those opinions. So these are going to be the qualitative methods. When I say qualitative, that means you are not gathering the data, you are not doing the data analytics, someone else has already done it and you are relying on the outcomes of that data. You are taking just the opinions of the people who have already done it. Then we have the time series projection methods. So here again, the simple linear regression we would try to use. If there would be a multiple variables, we will try to use the multiple linear regressions. Moving average method, in that too, there are certain extension to the moving average like ARIMA, ARMA, autoregressive moving average. You try to see that up to what extent we can apply this. Now, before that, let me make again a disclosure that when it comes to the syllabus, only this part is there in the syllabus, that is qualitative methods. But as I have stated to all of you, and it was promised from my side as well, that we would be doing the quantitative methods as well. Otherwise, there is no meaning of data analytics, right? Then there are certain causal methods which involves the cause and effect relationship. When I say cause, that means if you do something, then what would be the effect? If one variable is there, then what would be the effect on another variable? There are certain specific mathematical demand forecasting methods which will also be done. Let's go to the first one, which is a qualitative method. I hope everyone is able to see this. I have already shared the screen. If not, let me do it again. I think the screen is visible, right?
Yes. Those were
good. Okay, the first one is the jury of executive opinion method. Now, some people tell me that, sir, if we are not doing the data analysis, then can we forecast the demand? Why not? See, when we were establishing the grocery store in Rajkot, I was trying to see that, you know, what number of customers we may fetch in the entire day, how many people could potentially arrive on our shop, you know, what are the other landmarks which are near to our shop. Then one person who was there, who was a friend of my father, who was working in a marketing yard, he straight away came to us and say that you would get around 30 to 35,000 rupees of sales over here. And we were like, see, how can you be so precise? 30 to 35,000 rupees of sales. Effectively, he was just looking here and there. Then he identified there is a vegetable market there. Then he identified that, okay, these are the number of people who are will be, you know, daily going from this particular route. He had an idea about the demographics of the nearby locality too. And straight away, he said that 30 to 35,000 rupees of sales you will be able to make from this. Now see, it might not reach to our mind directly, but thing is that that fellow has got such an experience, that fellow is aware about so many other things, that fellow is already there into the industry from so many number of years now. He can predict it based on some subconscious and conscious information that he has already taken. And let me tell you, he was absolutely right. Our sales was somewhere near to that amount only. Now, when you perform the qualitative kind of a survey, at that time, you are not indulging yourself directly into the data analysis, but you are relying on someone who has already done it. And there is no wrong in doing that, right? So that's why in specifically the business management, sometimes the top management do not indulge themselves into the direct data analysis. They try to rely on the opinions of others. If such kind of an information is already been processed, is already been analyzed by few people, then take their opinion. You cannot ignore those people. No, I mean, if you are able to get it directly from the people, then take it. Why you want to do it? So it's like taking the opinion of those people who are already there into the industry. And person matters, I tell you. But one thing is that that person from whom you are taking the opinion must be having the integrity. Otherwise, you cannot rely on those opinions. If he is having the biases, if he is incompetent to give you the opinion, then obviously the entire result will go wrong. Warren Buffett has also said, no, that I looked for three things in the person. One is the energy, another one is the intelligence, and third one is the integrity. And if third one is not found, then I do not bother for the first two. So integrity is the most important factor, and that is built on the historical experiments, and you know, you have the experiences with that fellow. Anyway, so what do you do effectively in this is, you go to the people and you directly ask for the opinions, and obviously the people to whom you are going are already there in the business. You are taking their opinion that what could be the potential demand in the future. Now this is for the entire market. Now again you would try to analyze that what would be your potential share from this. For that too, there could be a simple calculations, you know, I'll come to that. Okay, so what you effectively ask in that what would be the major economic changes here? Do you feel that some changes would occur in the industry? Do you feel that, you know, the customers are having the buying powers? Do you feel that customers haven't changed their preferences? What do you see the kind of a change in the preference of the customers when it comes to these products? You try to take those kind of questions. Once you ask this, you come to know that what could be the future demand. Now see, this is also something which is bit numerical in nature. You try to take the opinion in an explicit manner expressed in numbers. You may ask it to them that what could be the potential number of quantity which can be sold over here? That's in numbers. Obviously, he will not be able to predict it directly. You can give them the range. And similarly, you can ask the opinions from the various people that what could be the potential range of quantity which can be sold here in this area or here in this location for this kind of a service and product that we are going to offer right now. So take their opinions directly and let's take it in a discussion. So that's the basic way, jury of the executive opinion. So when I say executive, that means those are the people who are already there at the higher position in that industry, and that's forming a jury. So when I say jury, these are the people who will be discussing among themselves as well after giving you the opinion, and then if they would be having any conflicts, then they would be solving among themselves and will give you exact idea about the things which are happening in the market right now. Simple to understand, easy. You know, you can see the various advantages of this. Then it comes to the Delphi method. The only difference between the Delphi method and the jury method is that in a Delphi method, the identity of a person who is giving the opinion would not be revealed. Because sometimes the people who are there in the industry, who are your contacts, do not want to reveal their identity. Say if you are taking the distributor license of Bajaj products, if someone is already there in the distribution line of the Bajaj, he do not want to form a part of the jury and discussion. He just want to give you the idea about the thing that what is there in the market. You want to take some inputs from him, but you do not want to reveal his or her identity. So that's the Delphi method. Very easy to understand. Again, a group of experts is sent a questionnaire. This entirely depends on how you frame the questionnaire, you know, what kind of things you ask in it. Then responses are received from the experts. They are summarized. And one good thing about this is, say, if once you receive the information from the people, no, you're not stopping over there. If you feel that there are major fluctuations in the opinions of the people, some people would be like 20 to 25,000 would be the demand, and some people would be like 50 to 55,000 would be the demand. Then you again send a questionnaire that why you feel that there would be a major fluctuations. If you get some extreme opinions about the things, you ask for the justification for their extreme opinions. Now, if the justifications are rational and intelligent enough, then you again try to go to some data that, okay, whether there's justification yet, you can again have the discussion among the people, like-minded people, that see, these are the people telling me a different kind of an observations which are very extreme in nature. What should we do about this now? Until and unless the agreement and consensus is not built, you would not be satisfied. And if there is a rational and justification given, then obviously you would be able to frame one bandwagon. You know, you will not be able to get the exact amount of demand, but the bandwagon, a range. So from one extreme to another extreme, try to reduce the range of the extremes as much as possible by having the discussion. And if you feel that both the rational cannot be ignored at all, then obviously you'll have to take the range, because now you cannot, you know, reduce the range further, because they are firm on their opinion and they have some specific logic to be believed. Okay, so this is how it would be. Now let's go to the third one, where I think you people would be the most interested. You people have brought the laptop as well. Today we would try to do some simple linear regression. No other softwares would be required. Some people would be like, sir, aap to har kuch Excel mein hi karte ho. To beta, isme hota hai, to fir main kyun na karu? So let's do it. You would be just writing the data which I have there. We would be starting with the very simple kind of a data file, and then we would move ahead further. I guess this will not be visible to you. Let me use the magnifier. Please copy this data somewhere in your Excel file, and then we will discuss it. And do not type 0 to 13 manually, huh? Otherwise that would be the great insult of mine. Some people would be like, aapke Excel ke professor kaun the ki aap 0 se 13 type kar rahe ho, aur meri wahan pe kam ho jayegi. So you would be writing 0, then equal to, select the cell, plus 1. Now you can just copy and paste it to other cells and take it up to 13. Some people will be like, sir, quantity ke liye kuch hai ke nahi aapke paas? Nahi, wo to type hi karni padegi. Aalsi mat bano, jaldi karne lago, chalo. Achha, all the students, the two methods we have discussed just now, are you clear with this? May I have the confirmation, please? Or you feel that a more discussion is required on that? Everyone?
Yes, sir. Clear.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good, good. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Some people are like, magnifier, magnifier. Okay, you have the magnifier here. Done? Okay, Miss Aruna has done it. Others may just give me the confirmation whether you have copied the data there. I don't think why statisticians are forcing us to use the other softwares sometimes. One person said to me that, what do you want to find? I said, I want to find the multicollinearity between the two variables when there is a multiple linear regression. He said that do R for this. But that can be done in the Excel as well. I said, no, use R. So, I mean, fancy words you have, so R use karna compulsory hai kya? Manually manually mein kar sakta hu, to tere ko kya problem hai? Mere paas hai. Aur bol rahe ki, एक्सेल तो है ना, वो तो डेटा एनालिटिक्स सॉफ्टवेयर है ही नहीं. बोला कैसे नहीं है, तो 10 लाख रो ऐसे ही दी हुई है क्या हमें? 16,000 कॉलम से 10 लाख रो ऐसे ही दी हुई है. ठीक है, इफ यू हैव अ बिग लार्जर साइज ऑफ द डेटा विच कैन नॉट बी प्रोग्राम्ड हियर इन एक्सेल, यू यूज द अदर. बट व्हेन यू हैव द सॉल्यूशंस, एंड वन मोर थिंग, इफ यू आर अवेयर अबाउट द फंडामेंटल्स, इफ यू नो दैट व्हाट्स द फॉर्मूला बिहाइंड द अरिमा, you manually type that formula and you can do the calculation, then also it's fine. No, if the ARIMA is not directly given to you in the Excel, अल्टीमेटली योर ऑब्जेक्टिव नीड्स टू बी सेटिस्फाइड। लेकिन उनको तो मजा आता है ये कर एसपीएसएस कर, तो बोला इसमें हो रहा है तो नहीं, नहीं फिर भी एसपीएसएस कर, सो स्टक फैंसी फैंसी वर्ड्स। Okay, then you have the two rows. Basically, we are trying to forecast the trend from here. Now, obviously, the time is going to be the independent variable. One person said to me that's a time co dependent variable. तो बेटा तो time co dependent ले लेगा तो भगवान हो जाएगा। You are God, अंतर्यामी. You cannot make time dependent. Okay, so obviously the dependent variable is going to be your quantity in thousands. So we have taken the lags actually, time lags. Time lags can be the quarter, time lags can be the yearly, time lags can be, you know, daily. Now here in this case, say for example, we have the time lag, which is yearly in nature. Now here, if we are able to identify that there is a specific trend observed upward or downward, then we'll just be projecting the forecast based on the linear regression. So you would have obviously studied it conceptually in Yashasar's lecture, which was the previous lecture as well. I can see that there are certain notations written over here in the board, SLR and MLR. I guess that is related to regression only, simple linear regression, right? Okay. So if I give you further idea, see, we just try to project the independent variable by assuming the linear relationship between the two. That means we altogether ignores the seasonality between the two. See, if this is a kind of a trend, let me just give you the example. Draw button has stopped working. I don't know why. Started. See, if this is the kind of a trend which is a seasonal in nature, you can definitely find that there is some correlation between few legs. See, here the correlation between the few legs, see, these legs are interrelated with each other. Here, rather than using the simple linear regression, for the projection, you may go to the time series analysis further in ARIMA or somewhere where this seasonality is taken into account. Right? But if you feel that, sir, we want to just predict it in a simple regression fashion, where you find that, you know, one variable is moving either upwards or downward in a linear relationship, then also it's fine. Here you'll not be getting the exact answers, but at least you will be getting the near about answers. So that's going to be the simple linear regression. Now here in this case, we want to extrapolate this trend. So we would be taking the time as the independent variable. How can we do it? I hope everyone should be able to find the data analysis tab in the data in Excel. If you can find it, let me know. Not there? It's there? Right. So how many of you have this data analysis there? Check it out. Here I have in the analyze section of the data analysis. May I have the confirmation from others? Do you have it or not? Jalpa, yes, is having good. Dhara is. Baki ke paas hai ki nahi hai? Heli ke paas bhi hai. Good. Okay, let's move ahead further. Then I would go to. And if it is not there, you can add the data analysis tab. Let me show that option to you as well, so that you would be absolutely clear. There is an extended version of the Excel as well, specifically for the statistics. Excel Stata, where ARIMA and all such sort of a modeling, which is advanced level modeling, is also included. Okay, here I am there on, just a second, file section. Then from file, there is a last option called options there, right? So you click on the options. This kind of a dialog box gets appeared. Now this is only if you do not have the data analysis tab with you. Now this data analysis tool pack is the additional tool pack in Excel, which is generally not required, but if in case you want, you can take it. So I would go to the add-ins from here. Then in add-in, you can see that Excel add-ins, which is the last one here. Let me use the magnifier again. So some people will be like, sir, nahi dikhai de raha. Either. Then you can go to this option, that is go. And you must be able to see that analysis tool pack is ticked over here. In case if it is not, you tick it and you just press OK. That tool pack would be visible to you now. Okay, let's move ahead. Data analysis. Then you go to the regression, which is by default. See here as well, you have so many other tests as well. For hypothesis testing too, you can take various tests from here. Regression, pressing OK. And once you press the regression, this kind of a dialog box gets appeared. Here in this case, Y is the dependent one. We want to project and predict which variable, Ms. Aruna? Quantity demand, right? So sir, Y range would be the quantity demand. Click over here and I would be selecting it. So if you are selecting the topic, then please put it in the back of your mind that you have selected the lobby label as well. So let me select it right from the labels to the last one. I have selected B numbers column from quantity in 1000 to the last one. Then pressing OK or just enter. Now again, I would be requiring the X range, which is going to be my time lags. So time lags could be anything for any time frame. Let me click over there. And I would again be starting including the heading, but I need to remember that I have taken the heading as well. Huh? From the first to the last one, pressing enter. Now here you would be selecting this label option because we have selected the topic too. If you would have fetched just the data, then there was no need to select this label option. Here we have already selected the topic. That's why we are selecting the label too. Now, whatever is there, just keep it as it is right now. Not going into the technicalities of it. We would be requiring this in a new worksheet. So I'm keeping it as it is. So where we want this output of regression to be, we want it in the same worksheet only, sir. Right now we are not going into the residual analysis. We'll go later on afterwards. We do not want the probability distribution too. So I'm just keeping it as it is, whatever is there, just pressing OK. And congratulations, you have a different worksheet there. This is how it looks like. भाई ये मेरे को मैग्नीफायर में बजाने यार, मैं इसको थोड़ा बड़ा कर देता हूं इधर से. ओके, सो बेसिकली व्हाट यू गेट ओवर हियर इज द मल्टीपल आर इज नथिंग बट द कोरिलेशन कोएफिशिएंट, व्हिच टेल्स यू दैट हाउ स्ट्रांग द रिलेशनशिप इज बिटवीन द टू वेरिएबल्स. सो इट्स द कोरिलेशन कोएफिशिएंट. यू कैन क्रॉस चेक इट बाय अप्लाइंग द कोरेल फंक्शन इन एक्सेल. सो यू हैव द कोरेल फंक्शन व्हिच गिव्स यू the idea about the correlation between the two. So equal to corel, opening the bracket, array one could be anything, it doesn't matter. So let me select the array one, comma array two is going to be my quantity, closing the bracket, pressing enter, and you have 0.9693, and that's the same I have got over here too, right? CORREL. Is it clear, Ms. Aruna? Good. Then there is a R square, which is a point of determination. You are aware about it. So that's basically the number of points which are fitting in the regression line. See, you have predicted something by using the regression line. How this regression line is made, the equation looks like this. You are also aware about that, right? If you are not, let me just show that to you. First, you take the intercept. Plus you take the beta, एंड बीटा के साथ यू वुड बी मल्टीप्लाइंग द वैल्यू ऑफ द वैल्यू थ्रू विच यू वांट टू प्रेडिक्ट. सो ऑब्वियसली योर वैल्यू वुड बी द वाई वैल्यू. सो यू वांट टू प्रेडिक्ट द एक्स, राइट? सो एक्स इक्वल टू इंटरसेप्ट प्लस बीटा मल्टीप्लाइड बाई द वैल्यू ऑफ वाई. उसमें y आता है, लेकिन y का मतलब क्या हुआ इधर? हाँ, राइट. सो y, y इक्वल टू इंटरसेप्ट प्लस बीटा मल्टीप्लाइड बाय द वैल्यू ऑफ x. यू वांट टू प्रेडिक्ट द डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल. गुड. सो नाउ इफ यू हैव दिस इक्वेशन, यू जस्ट अप्लाई दिस. इंटरसेप्ट इज नथिंग बट यू नो द प्रिडिक्टेड वैल्यू व्हेन द वैल्यू ऑफ x वुड बी जीरो. नाउ हियर आई एम यूजिंग द वर्ड बीटा. Excel people calls it a slope as well, and statisticians calls it the regression coefficient, and finance people calls it beta. So all in all are same only. So intercept you have got over here, that is 12.37, right? This is the beta, you may call it the regression coefficient. So say for example, if you want to predict it for say 13th time interval, then 13th time interval's equation would be looking like intercept is 12.37 plus the beta is nothing but, you know, the exact relationship between the two variables. If one is moving by one unit, the other variable would be moving by how many number of units? That's the beta or the regression coefficient. So 1.05 multiplied by, you want to predict for 13th time interval, right? So I am multiplying that with 13. So whatever you get would be the value of y at 13x. So that's the predicted value. Now, what matters, what does not matter to you right now? Some people would be like, sir, yes, significance F mein 1.13 E kya dikha raha hai? Bhaiya, kuch nahi hai. If the numbers is too large, no, Excel takes it like this. So it's nothing but 1.13 divided by 10 raised to 8. So you can imagine that your P value is coming so less. So statistically significant, obviously much lesser than 0.05. You can convert it in the numbers as well. Once you select it, you can go to the home tab. From here, just convert it into number. You may check it that it's much lesser than 0.005. So it's basically the analysis of variance. So regression is tested by this test. So by default, it has done the hypothesis testing, because regression is basically the inferential statistic only. You want to derive the conclusion from the sample and you want to apply it to the entire population. So that's why it has done the hypothesis testing here. ANOVA has been applied over here. So much lesser than 0.05. Individual variables, the t-test has been applied over in this case, and the p-value for those as well you can get. So you can let me know now. What's the meaning of this 7.97e-11, Aruna? 7.97 divided by 10 raised to 11. So E stands for the exponent. Exponent kiska, sir? 10 ka. Okay. So again, let me convert that into numbers. Numbers. Again, much lesser than 0.05. So our result is statistically significant. The null hypothesis is rejected. And when I say null hypothesis is rejected, that means whatever the conclusion you wanted to get, it's been reached. That means there is a significant relationship found between the two variables. Okay. So by this way, one can project the demand for the next time intervals. But we have taken few assumptions in this case. Number one assumption is there is a linear relationship between the two variables. There are all the assumptions which we take in the simple linear regression is also applicable over here. Now beta as well you can find by using one slope function in Excel, you know. So if you want to cross verify that whatever the beta you have got is the same by using the slope function, you can verify this. So let me use the magnifier here. So equal to, you can write slope, slope. Then it comes to the known y's, which is the dependent variable. Dependent variable is going to be the amount of demand right from the first to the last one. Here in this case, do not take the topics. क्योंकि फॉर्मूला को समझ में नहीं आता कि तुमने क्या डाला है टैक्स उधर, फिर वो एरर बताएगा. कॉमा टू गो टू द नेक्स्ट पैरामीटर ऑफ द सिंटैक्स एंड देन इट टेल्स यू द नोन वाइज नोन एक्स सॉरी द इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल्स. आई विल बी सिलेक्टिंग राइट फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट टू द लास्ट वन, क्लोजिंग द ब्रैकेट. यू हैव गॉट 1.05274. आई गेस दैट इज द सेम बीटा और द रिग्रेशन कोएफिशिएंट वी हैव गॉट देयर. The good thing about this is I know the Excel as well as the statistics as well as the finance. So beta would be I would be habituated with that word. Please do not mind it. आपको regression coefficient से problem है तो मैं उसको वो use करूँगा, कोई बात नहीं. So is it clear? May I have the confirmation till now? Whatever you have done, you people are absolutely aware about it. May I have the confirmation from you, Miss Aruna? Our next method for the projection is going to be the exponential smoothening, where we'll also take these errors into account. I mean, see, we have predicted some value. So what would be the difference between the predicted value and the actual value we have observed? So by taking those errors into account, we would try to do some exponential smoothing in the next lecture. Some people would be like, what is that? Kuch nahi samjha. To wo next lecture mein karne wala hai, to abhi samajhne ki zarurat bhi nahi hai. Abhi tak to samjha na? Till now you are clear, no? Good.
Yes, sir.
Good. Okay. So you can do the same for the large set of data as well. And I have taken just a small one to give you the brief idea about how we can do the regression analysis in Excel. You can do the multiple linear regression as well. So if you have, say, two variables, and from which two variables you want to predict one, then two independent variables will be taking place, right? So X would be two. So you can select the range of two variables. Excel will give you the answer. So let's take that kind of an example as well in the next session, and then we will move ahead to the exponential smoothening too. Let me just give you the idea, whatever, if anything is left or not. Okay, yes. R square is the determination. Then existed R square, you would take this R square if the number of variables are many. If the independent variables are two or four or five or many, you would take this existed R square instead of R square, because that would also adjust the variations and errors because of number of variables. Standard error, which is not the same as the descriptive statistic standard error you get, it is based on something else, no need to go into as of now. 14 is the number of observations we have totally taken, and then it has applied the ANOVA for testing the entire regression result. So our entire regression result is also statistically significant, and our individual variables are also statistically significant. If we'll be having two or more variables, at that time it would be better for us. That if one variable is not statistically significant, then what we'll do? Anyway, that's gonna be the question of the next session. Okay, so that's it from my side. You can just put your attendance. See you all in the next session. If you have any queries or doubt, you can let me know. Otherwise, you can just give me a confirmation that you have got everything till now. Oh, yes, your name needs to be written. Aruna. I spelled it correctly, right? Okay. Aruna will. Aruna is your first name?
My name is
only name Aruna. So how do you write your name?
My father's name is Kamal.
Okay, that's okay. Got it. Fine. No worries. If I'm making any mistake, let me know. Okay, bye-bye. Take care. Sayonara. See you all in the next session.